Good evening, everybody, and Zupalpana from Kolkata. I hope everybody is doing well and taking good care of themselves. So today I am here to share a review about an upcoming novel by author Shravana Roy, and it's known as The Etching of the First Quarters of 2020. So Shravana Roy is a civil engineer by profession, and he is also the author of 5 best-selling fictional books. So my first encounter with the author happened a few months back at an event organized by Solitaire in association with Ubuntu, the vegan community cafe in Kolkata. To be very honest, I had not read his previous books, and when he read out some pieces of his previous novels, I was really undoubtedly moved by the depth of his writing, and I could not resist getting introduced to him. So the 5 best-selling books are Pentacles, Frosted Glass, Abbey's Winter Poems, and Random Subterranean Mosaic, 2012 and 2018, Time Frozen in Myriad Thoughts. The author has been recognized for delving candidly into the psychological traits of human being in a smooth and subtle manner through his writing journey. Shravana Roy happens to be one of the most leading neo-modern writer of the postmodern era, who has never shied away from expressing the deep, dark aspects of duality and the contradictions of the human mind. I think this is a much discussed topic in present current scenario. And I think Shravana Roy has always, in his previous novels and in this Etching of the First Quarter of 2020, has been very candid and has expressed what we truly need to know. In the upcoming book, the author has delved deep into the latest developments in the fields of genetics and psychological studies, unfolding the myriad shades of duality in human behavior. As I started reading the book, which is a culmination of letters, ideas, conversations, and poems, the manifold facets of human mind, of the human psyche, in fact, started unfolding, which influences a person's conscious and unconscious actions. The author succeeds in his attempt to unravel the human mind and the heart, racking up characters from the pages of history and his own thoughts. He expresses in the most candid manner the dark sides of the mind of iconic political and literary characters such as Humbert, Lolita, Anna Karenina, and Nikolish. The author also enables his readers to understand in the most engrossing way duality and dualism of the human mind through the portrayal of the characters in his book. As the author takes a deep dive into the varied shades of the human mind, he breaks the many barriers of misconception related to these characters who personify duality of character and obsession. This indeed is, I think, again, a very challenging and courageous act by the author, who blends the psychology of fictional literary characters and actual historical figures. In the 2 different chapters, A Letter to a Stepdaughter and Nocturnal Conversation Between a Stepfather and a Stepdaughter Over Deserts and Coffee, the author expresses vividly the emotions, love, and the duality between a stepfather and stepdaughter through 2 different characters, Babuluza and Tulip. In A Letter to Suranjana, the author makes a refreshing attempt to excavate the split mind of Humbert in the narrative of Lolita, making literary scientific sketches of the human mind. Here the author reflects upon the fact that Humbert may deserve some greater understanding for humans. As I move on with the letters and conversation as part of the book already setting in and taking me to the unseen of the human mind, I find an anthology of 21 poems written by the author as the ending. I have a love of poetry anytime, and as I read through these poems, I find the author analyzing the split minds of human beings that have prompted writers over the ages to create immortal characters. I find myself reflecting upon my inner mind while reading the poems, and I'm sure all readers would do the same. As a poem express a vivid confrontation between the poet and his alter ego, there is also a deep reflection of human thoughts which enables the readers to scrutinize their own state of mind and examine the nature and paradoxes of human personalities. I think I have literally enjoyed reading the book, not only because of the depth, but because also I have come to know about so many new things related to human psychology. And I wish the author Shabana Roy great success in this book, the upcoming book, which is going to be launched soon, just like his previous books. And I thank him for the opportunity to write a review about it and have shared it on Facebook. Thank you everybody, and again good night, and I hope everybody takes good care of themselves. Bye bye.